Why you have the budget for us?
Good evening, everybody.
Good evening.
Welcome and Merry Christmas to our Christmas Eve service this evening.
And we hope that as we worship together, that we will remember the baby Bethlehem who came to show us God's love in the world. So this is a carols and lessons kind of service. And at the end, we will be singing Silent Night. There are directions on here. They're a little out of date, just so you're aware. Our special music tonight will be with Ryan and Emily, who are going to sing Light a Candle for Peace, which is one of Mitch Thomas's songs. And at the end, Ryan will play through Silent Night. Verse 1 will be sung by them. And then we'll sing all the rest of the verses and go back and sing the first verse as a congregation for each of those. So just to let you know that. You do not have to pop up and down and up and down during the hymns. We will stand for Silent Night. We'll make a circle around the sanctuary, and we will pass the light during the singing of Silent Night. So let us begin our Christmas Eve service with O Come, Emmanuel, which is 211 in your hymnals.
You can come sit over here and we'll just bring it over here.
And it is 1, 2, 4, and 6. Darkness have seen a great light. Those who lived in the land of deep darkness, on them light has shined. For a child has been born for us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. His authority shall grow continually, and there shall be endless peace for the throne of David and his kingdom. He will establish and uphold it with justice and with righteousness from this time onward and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. Our next hymn is 250, Once in Royal David's City.
The angel Gabriel was sent by God to a town in Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin engaged to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David. And the virgin's name was Mary, and he came to her and said, "Greetings, favored one, the Lord is with you." Our next hymn is 215, to a maid engaged to Joseph.
Augustus, that all the world should be registered. This was the first registration and was taken while Quirinius was governor of Syria. And all went to their own towns to be registered. Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to the city of David called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house and the family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged, and who was expecting a child. As we've gone through the Advent season, we have lit candles reminding us of who Christ is. Our first candle was lit, a reminder of Christ who is our hope. The second, of Christ who is our faith. The third is Christ who is our joy. And the fourth, Christ who is our love. And today we light the central candle, which is the reminder to us of the Christ who is our King. she gave birth to her firstborn son, wrapped him in bands of cloth, and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them in the inn. Our next hymn is Away in a Manger, verses 1 and 2. In that region, there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flocks by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord." Our next hymn is 229, Infant Holy, Infant Lowly.
Thank you.
them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, let us go now to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us.
Thank you.
after Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, wise men came from the east to Jerusalem asking, "Where is the child who has been born king of the Jews? For we observed his star and his rising and have come to pay him homage." When King Herod heard this, he was frightened, and all Jerusalem with him. And calling together all the chief priests and the scribes of the people, he inquired of them where the Messiah was to be born. They told him, "In Bethlehem of Judea. For so it has been written by the prophet, 'And you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah. For from you shall come a ruler who is to shepherd my people, Israel.'" Then Herod secretly called for the wise men and learned from them the exact time when the star had appeared. Then he sent them to Bethlehem, saying, "Go and search diligently for the child, and when you have found him, bring me word so that I may also go and pay him homage." And when they had heard the king, they set out on their ahead of them the star that they had seen at its rising, until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw that the star had stopped, they were overwhelmed with joy. On entering the house, they saw the child with Mary, his mother, and they knelt down and paid him homage. Then opening their treasure chests, they offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. Our next hymn is "We Three Kings."
Let us pray together our unison prayer. Eternal God, by the birth of Jesus Christ, you gave yourself to the world. Grant that, being born in our hearts, he may save us from all our sins and restore within us the image and likeness of our Creator, to whom be everlasting praise and glory, world without end. Invite you to stand and to make a circle around, and we will pass the light from one to another while Brian plays for us. That's why you need to have candles so you can actually.
Thank you.
how a simple light passed from person to person can connect people, not only within the circle, but even those who are outside the circle. Over this past Advent time, we've been remembering that Christ is here. He is our hope. He is our faith. He is our joy. He is our love. And he is our King. And as we go out into the world, the love that's represented by the light of Christ in the world is part of you within your heart. And it comes from you to the people that you meet, the people that you greet with love and compassion. So go out into the world remembering the light that Christ has set for you and share it with those who are outside our circle, but who still need to know the hope that is in God's love shown to us in Jesus. And go in peace. Amen.